This tutorial is brought to you by Envato Elements. Hello filmmakers, welcome to Storysium. In one of my last videos, I used this X-ray transition. Because I received a lot of questions about it, I thought it would be nice to do a dedicated tutorial video about this transition. This one is pretty easy and can be done inside Premiere. First, I'll show you the quick and basic version, and after that, the more complex one, which looks like this. Okay, time to move over to Premiere and start some editing. Inside Premiere, I've already got two stock clips on the timeline coming from Envato Elements. These are two clips from a man using a jumping rope. We're going to put these two together to create the transition. The first thing that we need for this is an adjustment layer. We can create one inside the project panel, click on the new icon and then select adjustment layer. For this one, you can use the default settings and click OK. We can now take this adjustment layer and drag it over to the timeline and place it on top of the other two clips. After that, I'm going to head over to the effects panel and search for the invert effect. You'll find this one under video effects channel. I'm going to apply this effect to the adjustment layer. And we can see the result of this effect right away. Inside the effects control panel, you could also do some adjustments if you like. By default, the RGB channel is selected, but you can also pick another one to get a different look. For this tutorial, we'll just stay with the RGB channel. And by the way, you can also play around with the blend percentage to give this another look. Okay, next we're going to change the duration of the transition. And to do this, we first need to put the playhead right between the two clips. And then I'm going to hold the shift key and press the right arrow key once to skip 5 frames. After that, I'm going to switch over to the razor tool by hitting the C key or click this icon here and then cut the adjustment layer at the point of the playhead. I want the transition to last 10 frames, so I'm going to hold the shift key again and press the left arrow key twice to move 10 frames back. And then again, cut the adjustment layer at the point of the playhead. Then I'm going to move back to the selection tool by hitting the V key or click this icon here and then select the cutoff part of the adjustment layer. And then I'm going to remove them by hitting the delete key on the keyboard. And this is how this basic transition looks with the duration of 10 frames. Next, I quickly want to show you an alternative to the invert effect, and that is the extract effect. You can find this one under Video Effects Adjust. If I apply this one to the adjustment layer, you can see that it's kind of similar, but only black and white. In some cases, I think that this might look better, so I wanted to show you this as an alternative for the invert effect. But for now, I'm going to disable this effect and we're going to continue with an advanced version of the invert effect. And for this one, we need to extend the duration of the adjustment layer, somewhere around 20 frames will do. So again, I'm going to use the shift key combined with the arrow keys to skip 5 frames. Okay, so now that we've got an adjustment layer of 20 frames, we can head over to the effects control panel and go to the opacity section and there enable the free drawing bezier tool. We're going to use this to create a mask. But first, we need to zoom out in the program monitor, so I'll set it to 10%. And now we've got enough space to draw a mask. You can create any shape that you like, but for this tutorial, we're going to use something like this. I'm going to animate this shape to go from left to right. And I can do this by enabling keyframes for the mask path. I'm going to click on this stopwatch icon to create the first keyframe. This keyframe now contains the value for the left start position of the shape. Now I'm going to move a couple of frames forward and then reposition the shape all the way to the right. This will create another keyframe. With these two keyframes, we've now created this animation. Let's have a look at it at full screen. Okay, I've got one more variant that I want to show you. And for this one, we'll also use the razor tool and we're going to cut the adjustment layer on every couple of frames. And then go back to the selection tool and randomly delete some of the parts of the adjustment layer. This will give a strobe or a flickering effect that will look something like this. If you enjoyed this tutorial, then you should definitely have a look at the website of our sponsor, Envato Elements. Envato Elements is a great source for all your creative projects. They offer millions of high-quality items like stock videos and images, music and sound effects, but also many transition templates and presets. If you want to try them out, then use the link in the video description to claim a discount on your first month. The links can be found in the video description. And that's it for this short Premiere Pro tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then please like the video. That really helps a lot. Anyway, as always, thanks for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.